Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial I will show you that how you can create this Godzilla versus robot fight scene in PowerPoint 2016. So first of all, let me show you that this animation is totally inspired from one of the animation of Sergio at codepen.io website. And this site is really great for 2D animation. If you want to get ideas for 2D animations, then you can visit this website. And let me explain you this animation if you want to replicate it in PowerPoint 2016. So first of all, we have the Godzilla. So if you watch carefully, then you can see that which parts of the Godzilla are moving. And there are only two of them. One is the head and another one is the arm, which is extending and reversing back. So as you can notice that which animation you can use for this effect is grocery, and that is only horizontally. And for the moving head, you can use the motion part, the down motion part. And both animations are the same for the robot as well. The heads are moving in the same direction but with a different delay timings. So let's get started and let me show you the same animation in PowerPoint. Here I have this animation. So only 5 animations has been used, and that is not the only part which you need to learn. You also need to learn that how you can draw these kind of objects in PowerPoint. And here you can see a list in the selection pane, all the objects that I have used, and that is the much important part if you seriously want to do the 2D animation in PowerPoint. And let me show you all the objects here. As you can see this list, and here I have further objects here which has been grouped into a single object like Godzilla body, but it has lot of separate parts, and let me show you them by ungrouping them. From the format tab, click the group drop down button and use ungroup command, and now you can see all the different objects that I have used in this presentation. Even there are further groups which has been combined into a single group. So let me ungroup this as well. And you can see that how I have drawn these shapes. So let me undo all this. This is just to give you an idea that how you can create more complicated animations in PowerPoint. What you only need to do is to draw the objects by yourself. And I think that is the most time consuming part. Not even in PowerPoint. Even if you want to use any other animation software, then you have to draw the objects by yourself and then you can later animate them. So let me collapse all this, and only 5 animations has been used, 2 for the 2 hands, 2 for the 2 heads and 1 for the building. So let me explain you the animations here. So let me delete all these. So first of all, I will animate the Godzilla hand, and if I move this hand, then you can see that there is another hand behind this one. So there are the objects. If you want to look into the objects by downloading the presentation, then you can go here in the selection pane. You can open the selection pane from the home tab by clicking on the select drop down button and use selection pane. And later you can ungroup all these objects to see further detail that which objects has been used to create a single picture here. Let me undo this. So first of all, I will animate the hand, and for this I will go to the animation tab, click the add animation drop down button and go to more motion paths. You can also open motion paths by clicking on this animation drop down list and go to more motion path. And if you find the path that you want to use here in this list, then you can simply click here. But I want to use the left motion path, so I will go here, more motion paths, and here I will choose left. Hit the OK key. let me select the hand and then zoom in, so it will zoom into that particular object. Okay, so I want to shorten the length of this animation, so I will select it right from this red point and will hold down the shift key while moving the path, so it will move into a straight line. If you don't hold the shift key, then you can see that if your mouse is not moving properly, then it will create a diagonal path instead. So it is better to hold down the shift key, and I will like to drop it just right here. Okay, so it's time to configure the animation here. So for the timing, I will use, as I always use with previous, with the duration of 1 second. Now open the effect option window either by double clicking on the effect or by right clicking on the effect and choose effect options. So here I only need the smoothness for the start and not for the end. And let me show you the original animation here. As you can see, the hand of the Godzilla, that it moves smoothly to the left but reverses back very quickly. So that's why I will use the start smooth, and that will be around, let's say, 0.33, and not for the end. And I would like to auto reverse this animation. I want the hand to go to the left and reverse back to the starting point, that is the green one. And in the timing tab, I would like to repeat it until end of the select. Hit the OK key and let's check the animation. Okay, now it's time for the head. Select the head, go to the animation tab, click the add animation drop down button and choose more motion path. And for the head, I will choose the down motion path. Hit the OK key and adjust the path by holding the shift key. And I would just like to drop it right here. And that is the problem with PowerPoint when you assign a very short path. So instead of adjusting it right here, it collapses it on the top of the starting point. So what you have to do is select the head and zoom in by holding the control key and then use the middle mouse button to zoom in and zoom out. And now select the animation here and hold down the shift key again, and you have to drop it a little further so it doesn't collapse back to the starting point. I think that's fine. Now set it to play with previous, and it will have a duration of 1 second, and I would like smoothness for both start and end here with a 0.5 second duration. And I would also like it to auto reverse. I mean, I would like the head to move down and reverse back to the starting point. And I would also like to repeat this animation until end of the select. Here, one more thing you need to note down, that if you look carefully, then you can note down that when I move the head, then it is moving behind the body. Let me change the color of this body for a while, and as you can see that it is behind the body, and that is the exact position it is showing you in the selection panel. Let's say if I move this object right from here and drag it right here, then the head will come on top of the body. So let me undo all this. Okay, so let me see the slideshow. And I think it's fine. So same effect has been used for the robot, and let me select this one, the head of the Godzilla, and go to the animations tab, click the animation painter once, and then click on the head of the robot, and it will replicate the same animation. But here only one thing you need to change, and that is the delay timing. I want the robot head to move after 1 second, so we don't need to change anything in the effect option, and only you need to add the delay timing here for the robot head. And now, however, you can replicate this animation as well on the robot head, but that will move the robot head into the opposite direction. I want the robot head to move to the right. And you can do this by clicking on the effect option and then click right, and that will change the position. However, it will also change the length of the path, so I have to shorten it manually. Select the effect, hold down the shift key, and I would like to drop it, I think, right here, because we are also going to move the building and it will stop right here, I think, and then the robot head and then the robot hand will move up to here. Okay, now open the effect option window, and I think everything is fine here because we replicate the animation using the animation painter, and I want the smooth end at 0 and smooth start at 0.33 as we use for the Godzilla hand. So let's see the final animation. Okay, we also need to add a delay timing for the robot hand, and that will be 1 second. Let's see the animation. Okay, I think I need to shorten this length a little bit. Okay, we need to adjust the duration to 1 second. Let's see the animation again. Okay, that's fine. And now we only need to spin this building. And for that we will use the spin effect. And as you can also see that I have drawn this oval here. Let me delete this one. And let me apply an animation on this object, and that will be spin. Set it to play with previous. And let me adjust the rotation degree to 55. I want to show you something, that why I have drawn an oval here and combined it with the building. Let me explain you that. Okay, now as you can see that this building is rotating at 55 degree, but the anchor point of this rotation is right here, and that is why this building is moving like that. But I don't want to show the bottom part of the building, and I want this building to move just between these directions. So what you can do here, you can draw any object, let me undo all this, like an oval, then later you can select the building and the oval and group them together. As you can see here, in the building, here is another object called oval 169, and that are the remaining parts which I have used to create this building picture here. So after grouping the oval with the building, as you will move the oval, it will also move the anchor point of the building. Let me move it further so you can understand it. As you can see, if I will move this object, it will move from that point right here. So it is up to you that how you want to adjust the objects on the slide. Let me undo this. Okay, so for the building, I will apply the spin animation, add animation, spin, set it to play with previous, and it will have a duration of 1 second. And a delay timing of 0.25 seconds. Open the effect option window. Sorry, 0.25. Open the effect option window. And for the rotation, I want to rotate this building to 28 degree. And you, for your presentation, you can experiment with different rotations. And I want to rotate this counterclockwise because it is already to the right and I want to move it to the left. So I will use the counterclockwise direction, and I want to use the auto reverse. I want this building to move 28 degree counterclockwise and then reverse back to its original location, so the animation become a loop. So any other thing I would like also like to repeat this animation until end of the slide. Hit the OK key and see the slideshow. I think that's fine. Only 5 animations has been used so far. So here is one more thing I would like to show you here before I end this lesson, and that is, let me expand this thumbnail view and make a duplicate of this presentation. And on the first slide, I will delete all these objects here to show you one thing, and that is, as you can see here, you can't see the bottom part of the building moving. However, the building is like that, and it should show the bottom part when I move it right here, but it is not showing you in the slideshow, as you can see here. That is because I have put a picture on top of this, and that is this picture with the half hologram here. So how I did this, I would also like to tell you that. So for that, what I did, I just like that, I duplicated the slide and remove all the objects. Go to the file, click save as, click browse, go to the desktop, create a new folder. I would like to name it PPT and save it as a JPG. Click the save button, and you can go for just this one. I just want to save the first slide as a picture, or you can also save the entire presentation into different pictures. So I will go with this one, just this one. And now later you can delete this slide, and at here what you can do, you can click on the insert picture, go to desktop PPT and insert this picture and just copy it right here up to this point. Let's see the slideshow. So I hope you will like this presentation. Let me know by leaving your valuable comments in the section below, and don't forget to hit the like button. So thanks for watching and take care. Yeah.